Welcome to the 200th consecutive episode of Christ Virtual Church. This once again comes from my heart to your home. And boy, I'm thinking about this. Been 200 weeks in a row that we've been together. I bet a lot has happened in your life since we first began meeting. And I would imagine maybe some difficult things have happened over that period of time, but I'm sure praying and hoping that lots and lots of good things happen. And so as we get ready to start today, let's just take a moment to thank God for all the blessings that were contained in these past 200 weeks. Let's thank Him for all the simple pleasures, and even thank Him for all the things that didn't happen to us, that could have happened to us. We know that we have a good Father who loves us from the deepest place in His heart. Let's begin now by singing together. Here's our band recorded live in worship with Good Father.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never
I am your good.
Happy Sunday! Well, it has been said that people are like sticks of dynamite. There is power on the inside, but nothing happens until the fuse gets lit. Today, ladies and gentlemen, the Holy Spirit is going to light your fuse. Ready? Take your hands right now and stretch them out in front of you. Stretch your hands out in front of you and tell me what you see. I'll tell you what you're looking at right now. You are looking at the hands of God. It's true. God has no other hands in this world other than your hands and my hands. If he wants to reach someone, if he wants to teach someone, if he wants to hug someone, if he wants to help someone, he has no other hands in this world other than our hands. Your hands are the hands of God. And stretch out those hands one more time, and now do this. Take one hand and reach over and feel your wrist. Do you feel a pulse right there? Because let me tell you something, if you feel a pulse, if you've got a pulse, you've got a purpose. If you've got a pulse, you've got a purpose. If God didn't have a purpose for you, he could just take you to heaven right now. Just turn in your keys at the front desk and check out right now. But God is keeping you in this world. And God is keeping you in this world because he has a reason for that. You're not just here to take up space and use up oxygen. No, if you've got a pulse, you've got a purpose. God wants to make a difference with your life. God wants you to serve him with your life. And I don't care how young you are or how old you are, God is calling you. But Jeff, you might say, you don't know all the weaknesses I have. Jeff, you don't know all the problems that I have. Well, come on now. Name one Bible character. Name one Bible hero that didn't have problems, that didn't have weaknesses. Moses was a murderer. David committed adultery. Noah got drunk. Elisha wrestled with depression. And Peter, he denied even knowing Jesus, yet God rocked the world with them. Imagine what God can do with you and me. You say, but Jeff, you'd want to quit too. You'd want to quit too if you had my problems. Well, maybe that's true, but I wouldn't. I wouldn't because I know that anybody who ever accomplished anything in this world first had to go through some tough times. For example, Colonel Sanders of Kentucky Fried Chicken fame, tried to sell his secret recipe to over 1,000 restaurants, and he was turned down every time until finally one agreed to buy it. Walt Disney went to over 100 different banks trying to find financing for a theme park, and every single bank rejected him. He was also fired, by the way, from his job at a newspaper because he, quote, lacked imagination. George Lucas spent more than 4 years running around Hollywood trying to shop his script for Star Wars. And numerous studios said it would never work. They didn't believe in the project. It wasn't right for them till finally he found one that would take a chance on him. Wayne Gretzky, the greatest hockey player of all time, when he entered the NHL, they looked at him and they reported the following, quote, he's too small, too slow, and probably won't make it. Henry Ford went bankrupt 5 times. In fact, when Henry Ford built his first car, he forgot to put a reverse gear in it. Now, how about you? That's the question I'm asking right now. How about you? Reach over right now once again and feel that pulse pumping. Feel the air flowing in your lungs. Feel the life surging through you. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've got a pulse, you've got a purpose. And more than that, if you've got a purpose, you've got to get plugged in. Let me say it again. If you've got a purpose, you've got to get plugged in. God gave you talent. God gave you ability. God gave you a one-of-a-kind personality. But you can't sit on the sidelines with all of that. He wants you to join together with other people and make things happen. And the church is God's system to pull it all together. Four things the Bible teaches about the church. Four fast facts. Number one, we are the body of Christ. What Jesus did when he was walking around in this world, doing all the things that he did, he wants to do now through you. We are his hands. We are his heart to love the world. We are his body. Number two, you got to be connected. The Bible says in Christ's body, we're all connected to each other. You got to get connected. Notice, not just to God, but to each other. I mean, think of it this way. What good is a hand if it's not even connected to the body? If I cut off my hand and leave it laying over there in the corner, what good is that? It's dead. If I pluck out my eye and leave it in a jar on a shelf, what good is that? It's not serving the purpose for which it was created. You've got to be connected to the Bible or to the body to serve the purpose for which you were created. And then fact number three, everyone's important. Everyone. You say, but Jeff, I'm just a toenail in the body of Christ. Well, hey, did you ever lose a toenail? You felt it, right? Once I had an injury on my foot and they had to remove just a little corner of my nail on my big toe, and I felt that pain for like a year afterwards. Just a tiny part of the body, but it felt pretty important. And the Bible says that everyone is important. Everyone is needed. Everyone has their own part to play. And then fact number four, today's the day. Today's the day to get connected. Today's the day to get plugged in. I'll tell you what, you are a great part of this Christ Virtual Church audience. And I know we can track this, that over 400 people a week usually watch this service. And I am grateful for every single one of you. I appreciate that you're out there and you are a part of this ministry. But I just want to give you a special invitation. If you're watching this locally near us, I would love to invite you to come on in sometime and join one of our live worship celebrations. Come on in and plug in that way and meet some people. You will find the greatest people, the most loving, friendliest people in the world right here in this place. And right about now, this time of year, we're also highlighting all the opportunities we have in our church. When you come in, maybe you'd like to, you don't have to do it right away, just come visit, check things out, but maybe at some point you'd like to be a part of a Bible study, or you'd like to sign up your children for Discovery Hour on Sunday mornings, or you'd like to volunteer for something. Maybe you're an electrician or a landscaper, a plumber or a painter. Hey, we've got room for you. We would love for you to be a part of our team. Maybe you can sing or you can teach or you can play an instrument. Oh, we would love for you to be a part of our team. You've got a purpose, so why not come in and get plugged in? Today's the day that you can become a belonger. Not just a believer, a belonger. A lot of times we like to say, I believe in Jesus. Well, maybe we ought to say, I belong to Jesus. Because if you're a part of the body of Christ, you don't just believe in Jesus. You belong to Jesus. And more than that, you belong to every other person who belongs to Jesus. We belong to each other, and we need each other. If you've got a pulse, you got a purpose. If you've got a purpose, you got to get plugged in. And just one more thing. If you get plugged in, you're going to please God. You are going to please God. God is going to bless you. God is going to bless those you love. Jesus said, great is your reward in heaven. Jesus said, I am coming and I'm bringing my reward with me, and I will reward each individual for the work that they have done. You know, One day, you will draw in your last breath and you will let it go. One day, you will close your eyes for the last time in this world. And immediately, you will see the light of another world. And perhaps you will be like Elijah. God sent a chariot of light, a chariot of fire to pick up Elijah and bring him straight to heaven. You know, like the old gospel song says, swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Well, maybe God will send a chariot for you. And if he does, I know that you're going to jump onto that chariot with a great big smile on your face. And I can just see you now. I can see you climbing up higher, higher, higher through limitless space. You will move upward, upward, upward through the beautiful stars, ever upward. And I see you now as you're entering into the eternal city, the city of light, the home of our God and everything you have ever dreamed of. The prize you have so long sought is at hand. See the gates as they fly open wide for you to enter. See the herald angels standing on shining battlements and hear the glad shouts, she's coming. He's coming. He's almost here. He's almost home. And as you go through the sweeping gates of pearl, up along the shining way, you make your way to the very throne of God in the center of the city. And Jesus stands up when he sees you. And he stretches out his arms to welcome you. And you notice the deep purple scars in his hand from his crucifixion. And what does he do? He smiles and he throws his arms around you in a great big bear hug. And he says, welcome. Welcome home. Well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter now into the joy of the Lord. Oh, just seeing Jesus with your own eyes and hearing him say those words to you, that will be reward enough. Oh, men and women, our turn will come soon enough. By the grace of God, the gates of heaven are now open. And soon you will hear the voice of Jesus say, well done, my good and faithful servant. You've got a pulse. You've got a purpose. And now you've got a plan to please God. Let's bow our heads and come before him. Lord Jesus, I believe and I belong. Lord, I believe in you. I believe that you are the Son of God, sent from heaven to be our Savior. And I believe that I am a sinner in need of a Savior. Jesus, please be my Savior. Lord, you entered the world in a little town called Bethlehem, the son of a carpenter. You helped the hurting, hugged the children, and taught a new way. You walked the dusty streets of Galilee. You died on the cross of Calvary. You rose from the dead, and now you want to live again in this world, in me. So from now on, I'm not just a believer. I'm a belonger. I've got a pulse, and I've got a purpose. And I'm going to plug in and please you. I'm your hands, your heart, your hug. I'm your body making things happen in the world today. Lord Jesus, my Jesus, I believe and I belong. Amen. And let me just give you a special, special blessing at this moment. My friends, God is leading you. Heaven is open to you. And goodness and mercy are following you all the days of your life until you receive your reward in the glory of heaven. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now we pray together as the Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Well, again, we are so grateful that you're a part of this ministry and that you join us every week. And I pray for you all the time, and I think about you all the time. But I just got to say one more time, if you're around here and you're ever free, we would love to have you attend one of our live services. You know what? We don't call them a mass. We call it a celebration. Because you know what? There is joy in the house of the Lord. Here's our band recorded live in worship with House of the Lord. Well, thanks so much for joining us today. Next week, we're going to begin a brand new series, a super positive, motivational series called How to Feel 20 Years Younger. Some of you are listening right now, you're saying, well, that sounds really good to me. Others of you are thinking, Jeff, I'm like 12 years old right now. If I go back 20 years, I'm going to go like poof. Well, okay, if you're under 20, flip the whole thing upside down. And the theme for you will be how to feel like you're 20 years old. Hey, and if you thought today's talk was helpful, if it was positive, if it was encouraging, well, go ahead and give me a like on Facebook, share it on Facebook, tag a friend, just keep it going. And if you're a part of our Christ Virtual Church family, I just want to encourage you to be like so many people who watch every week, and they're a part of this ministry. They're a real part of this ministry. And how so? Because they give us a daily prayer. They pray for us every day. They give us a weekly gift. They support this ministry. And I'll tell you what else you can do. As I said, you can join us in a live worship celebration anytime you're free. But until then, our final act of worship is to bring our gift to God right now this morning. And I invite you to go to clcsouthwick.org. And right there on our homepage is a giving tab. But first, I send you out with these words of blessing. Now may the risen Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of life, the defeater of death, may he be with you this week to walk ahead of you, to lead you and guide you, to walk behind you, to support you and strengthen you, and to walk right beside you as your best and closest friend. Amen. And go now with joy. We will, for we go with God. Hey, have a terrific week, everybody. I hope I hear from you soon. I hope I meet you soon. And I hope, more than that, that you have a great week and that you feel the presence and the blessing of God every single day of the week ahead. Thanks, everybody.